Yo, what is good, yo? It's your boy Zab back here with another video. And in this video today, I am going to be doing a squad builder, building a squad with 100,000 MT. So if you're just starting the game, let's say you have nearly 100,000 MT, what is the best squad that you can make? Now, I was pretty comfortable and confident with each and every one of my selections on this list outside of the backup small forward. The backup small forward to me, it's probably the toughest position that I had to fill because I didn't have enough MT to get the guy I wanted. And we're going to cover that when I get there. But before we dive into everything and in this specific squad, if you are new to my channel and have not yet, please consider smashing that subscribe button as we're on the road to 70,000 subscribers. So we're going to start it off here with the point guard position. And we're going to go with the guy who last year made a little bit more of an impact. And I feel like a lot more people ran the Wes Unseld point guard card than this year. But that's not to say this year Wes Unseld is not still elite. He has a Kobe Bryant base on very quick. His player model, at least on current gen, is absolutely incredible. And if you look at what Galaxy Opal Wes Unseld gives you, he gives you everything, right? He goes right now for 11,000 MT, which to me is not a bad price. You're going to see a lot of added position three players on this list. It's not a bad price. He kind of got overshadowed by a lot of some of the other top players in the added position three set, and rightfully and deservedly so. But Wes Unseld just kind of flew under the radar as a solid point guard in this game. Now, is he a top five point guard in the game? Absolutely not. But is he a point guard that you can play that can compete on the defensive end with some of the top point guards in the game, as well as not being a complete liability on the offensive end? Absolutely. And that's why I have Wes Unseld at my starting point guard position. I'm not going to sit here and hype him up as the best point guard in the game, but he's a guy that I have no questions, similar to a guy that I'm going to run on my bench unit, that can just hold it down. At the shooting guard position, we're going to go with 7 feet tall Yalen. Now, here's the thing. Has the jump shot, 70, the Jonathan Isaac type release. He's basically he's a Jonathan Isaac, a little worse version of Jonathan Isaac that can play shooting guard. That's kind of the best way I can phrase it. Yes, I like Jonathan Isaac's defense a little bit more, but he on the offensive end is going to be elite. He's 7 feet tall. He moves similar to a Kevin Durant type card at the shooting guard position. No Curry escape, but for the card, it doesn't really matter. Defensively, because he's 7 feet tall, he's going to be able to compete pretty well. Not as yet at the shooting guard position, he's a mismatch versus the smaller shooting guards. If you run up against a guy running like a Zach LaVine at shooting guard, Yalen is going to give that Zach LaVine plenty of problems, specifically on the offensive end. So for a card that goes for 12,000 MT, another out of position three card, I think he's solid. A lot of these cards are just going to be that solid type of card that aren't necessarily incredible on one end or the other, but just are solid all-around cards. No different at the small forward position. Jeff Green, he's a card that, quite honestly, when he came out, I was hyping up more than I probably should have been. He's 9,000 MT, so for that price, the dude is absolutely incredible. I even ran Jeff Green in some competitive type of like wagers, and I would say I didn't green as much with Jeff Green as maybe I'd want to, but defensively, he can compete. Offensively, he gets good animations. In my opinion, he's a similar card, and he's going to give you similar things to that of a James Worthy type of player. Animation-wise, very solid. Release-wise, solid enough. Gets good defensive, offensive animations. And that's probably who I would compare him to most out of any other player in the game. He's just another version of James Worthy that goes for 9,000 MT. And honestly, the small forward position is where the toughest to fill, because a lot of the cards that I wanted to put on this were 15, 20,000 MT. And you just couldn't make that happen. I have one over 20,000 MT player on this squad, and that guy is coming up. Actually, he's coming off my bench, but we'll get to him later on in this video. At the starting power forward position, card that goes for 11,000 MT in Dino Raja, a card that can play in any type of a setting. If you just pick up the game today, pick up Dino Raja. If you play in a competitive type level, he can play for you. I don't think he's a top tier card to play, especially with some of the new content we got. But he definitely can play and compete at the highest level. Has a nice jump shot. He moves well. And it's just Dino. I'm pretty sure it's his wingspan more than anything, the reason why Dino will always be relevant in 2K. But this Dino is very comparable to the Dino that we did indeed get last year. His jump shot is jump shot 4, I believe, but Dino's jump shot 4 does not remind me of everybody else's jump shot 4 in the game. He just has his own specific one, which I think is very good, and it's unique for Dino. The fact that you can green consistently with the card, he's elite on defense. Offensively, he's going to get the job done. For 11,000 MT, Dino Raja is very solid. And at the center position, we're going to go with a guy who I'm not necessarily the highest on in the game. Now, he's the new Chris Bosh card. Now, When I say I'm not the highest on him in the game, I'm not low on Chris Bosh by any means. He's very solid in the game. I do love his release. It's just, I wish I could play as somebody just maybe a little bit better. He's 7,000 MT, and offensively, he's going to be elite. He's going to be one of the best offensive bigs in the game. Is he as good on the defensive end as a card like Dino? Absolutely not. But offensively, he's incredible in the pick and pop setting. He can compete on the defensive end. But it all comes down to the release that Chris Bosh has. If Chris Bosh did not have that release, I would not be nearly as high on him as I am. So the new Splash Zone Galaxy Opal Chris Bosh definitely makes the cut. So if you look at my squad, I got Wes Unseld 12,000, Yi Yalen, Wes Unseld's 11,000, Yi is 12,000, Jeff Green is 9,000. So far between them, we're looking at 32,000 MT. Dino's 11K, 43,000, and then Chris Bosh is 7K at the time I did my research. So through and through, my starting lineup is right at 50,000 MT, which means for my bench unit, we have 50,000 more MT to spend. And we're going to start it out definitely balling on a budget with the Pink Diamond Obi Toppin card. A card I've honestly never used in 2K. I'm just going to be straight up honest with you guys right here, right now. I've never used Obi Toppin. I've came up against the card and he can move. He can move. He has good length. He has good height. I just think, again, he's an out-of-position three player, the third out-of-position three player we've seen on this list who just gets overshadowed by some of the top guys in the game. And since Obi is the pink diamond, I mean, even guys like Wes Unseld and Yalen overshadow what Obi Toppin can do. I know we got the Galaxy of Obi that was definitely a huge letdown within the game, but don't let that sway your opinion. This pink diamond Obi Toppin card is still very solid, and card that goes for 3,000 MT, he is tough to beat. A card that I'm going to talk about for maybe a little while here is the Galaxy Opal Josh Smith card. I think his best position is the shooting guard position at 6'9", and I think he belongs on this list right here on this squad builder. 11,000 MT for Josh Smith. The only downfall to Josh Smith that I'm going to tell you guys is his release. I just don't know if it's his upper or what it is. It's harder to green with Josh Smith than it should be, because I think he does have the John Wall base, if I remember correctly. But his upper just throws it off. It throws the whole release off for me. Still, Josh Smith on the defensive end is going to be immaculate. Attacking the rim, he is going to dunk on people. And when I was thinking about the shooting guard position, yes, you could have went in a variety of ways. But Josh Smith at 6'9", still deserves to be on this list. Although I'm not as high on him as I once was. So at the small forward position, the guy I wanted to plug in here was Jonathan Isaac. But when it came down to it, MT-wise, it just didn't work. So another guy we're going to look at here and plugging in here is the new Splash Zone Pink Diamond Matisse Thybulle. Now, I get it, guys. He has the Justice Winslow type base, which I don't know exactly how that's going to look on Matisse Thybulle. Again, another card I have not used. But Matisse, he's cheap, guys. He is super cheap, obviously, a Pink Diamond in the new Splash Zone set. But he's not bad. Has a good three ball. Defensively, I think it comes with a base 99 lateral quickness. So he's going to be able to lock down some opponents. And he's got 40 plus Hall of Famers. So he's super cheap. His release should be decently easy to green. He's got the shooting badges he needs. Although he's not necessarily the best player in the game. Once again, he is a new Splash Zone player. So he's going to be juiced up as far as Hall of Fame badges and others are concerned. Comes down to it. As long as you got Matisse Thybulle's release down, he is going to be a very solid card to use in the game. Would I like him over Jonathan Isaac? Absolutely not. But when it comes down to MT-wise, you gotta do what you gotta do. And that leads me to my power forward. The most expensive player for me that I have on this entire squad is the Pink Diamond Bol Bol. Yes, the Invincible Bol Bol, the Dark Matter is better than Pink Diamond Bol Bol. But Pink Diamond Bol Bol is still incredible. 25,000 MT. You could probably get a juiced up Bol Bol, a few extra Hall of Famers for maybe 30,000, and the dude's incredible. Movement wise, you're not going to beat what Bol Bol is going to give you. The Brook Lopez base is one of the most overlooked bases in 2K. That release is so easy to time, it's so easy to green, as long as the upper on it is not broken. We've seen some releases that have like the Brook Lopez base that just don't look smooth. But Bol Bol's not that. His upper, I think, is Karl Malone's, and it is very smooth. 25,000, it might seem juiced for a Pink Diamond, but trust me when I say the Pink Diamond Bol Bol is more than worth it. Last but not least, the card for 5,000 MT is the Pink Diamond Anthony Davis. So if you look at my bench, yes, Obi's 3K, Josh Smith's 11K, you got Bol Bol 25K. So between there, you're looking at nearly 40,000 MT, and then it's basically 5K for A. Disney and 5K for Matisse Thybulle. So pretty well balanced as far as MT-wise. AD, what he gives you, Basically, just think of a downgraded version of the Dark Matter Anthony Davis. That's really what he is. Either are they going to feel that much different? They might not feel that much different. He does definitely have less Hall of Fame badges. He might not feel near quite as good, but he's going to give you 95% of what the Dark Matter Anthony Davis does. Majority of people that would use Anthony Davis are going to be people who've used him in the past. So his release should not be an issue for you guys. So this squad is under 100,000 MT. And quite honestly, if you give me this squad, I personally think I can compete in nearly every setting. That's up against the Invincible Kareems, the Invincible Shaqs of the world. Obviously, these guys aren't the best players in the game, but they're players that I believe can hold it down against those top-notch players, or players that you can take into My Team Unlimited and can get by and have a lot of fun with. I'm sure I missed out on a cheap budget baller within this video here for you guys today. So if I missed out on a key one, let me know that down below in the comments. Just did some brief research and this is the list that I personally came up with. Drop a like on the video. Subscribe if you are new, and as always, man, I love you guys and have a blessed day.